everybody. Welcome to Working Horses with Jim. Today we are going to be working on putting single shafts on the cart. Jim's planning on using Lady this morning, and we'll see how it goes with her. We'll have some more lady power. And I'm on the way out to the barn. Look at all the apples. Apple tree is doing so good this year. Apple pies and applesauce are in our immediate future. And I just wanted to thank everybody for all the support they gave. From the last video when I shared that I was leaving my job to be here on the farm full time. And I've got lots of work to do. There's a lot of things to can and all that. And we've already been out in the barn this morning stacking hay. But this morning, Jim wants to get the shafts fitted for Lady so that he can, there you are, showing all the mess, so that he can ted. Right?
Right. I don't know what you said, but right. it's, of course, way too wet. We can't start tedding for a few hours, but let's just get the cart over here and then we'll get the shafts on it and get it ready to go.
Okay.
My Amish neighbor has been using this cart for quite some time now, so I finally asked them to bring it back because I needed it, and so we're going to be able to use it now, which is great.
Okay, put it directly underneath that pipe. I took a sander, a palm sander, and smoothed them off. Feeling hard edges?
Feels pretty good, doesn't it? Yeah, it'll, right here it's a little bit. That's just bark. Let me just check over here. Yeah, it feels good.
So to me it seems a little bit heavy, but it also seems a little crooked too as far as on the cart, but all we can do is hitch it up and try it.
Ready to go out and ted some hay with Lady. There's a lot of different ways to hitch onto shafts with a horse, and I don't even know which way I prefer doing. I'm going to do some more experimenting as we go along and try to tell you what way I do like to do it best. So after you get the tugs hitched, then you have to hitch the hold back chains. In my situation, these are chains to the ring on the britchen, as you can see. Okay. That will help it to hold back a load and to back up a load. Since this was Lady's first time, I wanted to just take a loop around here, the driveway, and before I start the tether up to make sure she reacts okay.
I decided to let Brenda drive, and this will actually be a really good job for her and other inexperienced, although she's got quite a bit of experience, but inexperienced newcomers as far as driving. This is also something for homesteaders to be thinking about if they have just one horse. The amount of different jobs that can be done with one horse. It's a bit of an investment to buy a cart like this, but it's be a lot cheaper than buying a tractor, and these little Honda motors are so cheap to run. It's a great way to do things, and there's a lot of things that you can pull with this, especially for just a single horse. A lot of things you can do. The hay is drying, but it's not much of a hay day today. That tether does a wonderful job of kicking the hay up and around. So what I told her to do is just go up to the end. This is a very narrow piece. So, and it comes to kind of sharp corners. So I said, just go up there and kind of come down the center with Lady. And then we'll just work across the field this way. A couple good looking women right there. One thing I really like about using a single horse in the hayfield, especially, Bill and Lady is a main team that I have, but their pace, the speed that they both go is quite a bit different. Lady is a lot slower than Bill, so it's, in a lot of ways it's hard to keep them together as a team. But when they're both working single, they can go the pace that they want to go and what they're used to and what is just best for them, and that works great. I'm feeling that the shafts are a little bit heavier than I would like them to be, but she has a good back pad, and it's, so it's supported completely from her back. And actually, to tell you the truth, it's probably a lot less or not much different than having just somebody ride the horse. and no weight is on their neck, which is a good thing. She's walking along beautifully. I think Brenda will have a lot of enjoyable times working a single horse like this. For me personally, she's walking way slower than I would like her to go. But for Brenda, I think she will really enjoy it. One problem we have when tedding hay, the second time I tedded this once yesterday, when it was still in the swaths from the mow machine were still visible. And so it was fairly easy to know where to ted. I actually ted two swaths at a time, which doesn't give me complete coverage, but it still does very good. And but the second time around, it's very difficult to know where to go. You're doing a lot of guessing because you can't really tell. It actually throws it to the side somewhat and it covers up where you need to go. But as long as that first tedding is done properly, I'm not so concerned with the whatever you ted after that, because you'll miss some and some you go over twice, but that's okay. I should have brought my lawn chair out. What do you think? So I'm going to throw a question out there for everybody. I'm curious to know how many people, even now, are working a single horse. Love to have you put that in the comments below and tell me what you're doing with a single horse. Or what have you done with a single horse this week? Are you really working a single horse? And then, if not, what have you done in the past with a single horse? I thought it might be a good time while Brenda's tedding the hay to come in and check on my corn crop. I'm fairly pleased with the way my corn is looking. I have some nice big ears. Maybe I'll open this one up and see what it looks like. That's kind of a bad one. Let's open this one here up, see what this one looks like. We have kernels right to the end of the cob. Here it is, September 3rd, maybe, something like that. And that's a nice ear of corn. Completely filled out. It's even starting to dent a little bit right there. Now, if you were to recall back when I planted this stuff, I had like three different varieties in here. So which one this one is, I don't know. But anyways, it looks really, really nice. The corn is probably, I don't know, 8 or 9 feet tall. Nothing spectacular for height, but I don't really care because I'm not cutting it for silage, I'm just cutting it for, I mean, I'm picking the corn. You got 2 ears on a lot of these. Not all of them, but a lot of them. It's going to make a very nice crop in a few months when I pick it. I'm not sure where I'm going to store it all. That could be the problem. But anyways, enough of my cornfield, my corn crop. Let's get back and make sure Brenda's doing okay in the hayfield. After we finish this tedding up, we'll have a bite to eat, and then I'm going to head to the woods for half a day in the woods, but we won't show you that. I guess I'll go ask Brenda if she wants to continue. I can go get some work done in the barn and get the other two harnessed up, because I'll be using Buck and Bill today in the woods. So Brenda said she's going to finish up here, and I'm going to get the horses ready for this afternoon. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Have a great day.